battle race against time for the two remaining Tulsa Race Massacre survivors as they continue to seek justice in a lawsuit against the city of Tulsa for what happened more than 100 years ago. Their legal teams made a final push yesterday afternoon before the state Supreme Court. News 4's Ashley Moss has the story.
Now, a favorable decision would be historic and monumental. And these folks say their request is simple. They want the justices to make a decision while Miss Leslie Randall and Miss Viola Fletcher are still alive.
But we're not looking for a miracle. We're just looking for them to apply the law as written.
Standing on these steps, this group says there's still no respect, no repair, no restitution for what happened in 1921.
It's been 102 years. Since Greenwood was bombed from the sky, since houses was burnt down to the ground.
The attorney says this is a final call to compensate the survivors and their descendants.
There is no going to the United States Supreme Court. There is no going to the federal court system. This is it.
They hope to prove their case in court.
We should get to go to trial, and we should get a chance to actually prove the case, just like any other plaintiff in Oklahoma gets.
But time is of the essence.
It's hard to put the urgency in words, particularly when I'm standing here right next to Uncle Red's family, and he's not here.
By Uncle Red, he means Hughes Van Ellis, the youngest of the remaining massacre survivors. The World War II veteran testified before Congress in 2021.
I hope we all will work together. We are one.
I was able to sit there and hear him say, "Please don't let me die without getting justice."
Unfortunately, it's not justice Mr. Van Ellis saw on this side of life. He died in October from cancer at 102.
And we pray that the court treats us, as Uncle Red always says, as one, equal under the law, so that we can have our day in court.
At the state Supreme Court, Ashley Moss, Oklahoma's News 4.
We are one.
Perfect.